Oh boy. Oh boy, we're streaming again. Let me turn the text off there. Just a friendly reminder, gout is a serious disease and you should definitely donate. Donate to cure this affliction and to save the people that suffer with it. I know one individual who has a terrible case of gout. He's a stand-up guy. And without that gout medicine, we may never get another Let's Play. So we really need to cure this fucking disease. So, in case you missed it, somebody started a new channel. I know it's remarkable. It's a little bit of a secret. Keep it. Don't tell anybody. It's important that nobody finds out that this channel exists. I like the explanation he gave in regards to how people found his channel. Oh, it showed up in the related videos. Oops. How could that have happened? Maybe because he links his fucking Patreon and his t-shirt site and his website in the description. And he probably has, if I could look at the tags of the video that I'm going to show you in a minute here, I'm going to guess that it's just loaded up with a DSP. I've let the cat out of the bag now, haven't I? Oh, that's right, chat. Broken channel mechanics. It is shameful. It's shameful that YouTube let that slip through the cracks. So let me pull up monitor capture here. And I'll show you his amazing video. You're gonna be wowed. Sit back. This is a you're in for a treat. You're gonna see what a professional looks like when he does a channel trailer. Let me just cue this up here.
Hello.
Oh, don't wanna lose it too quickly. Okay, I think we're good. Prepare yourselves for the next evolution of video game channels. I hope you're ready for this. I hope you're all super fucking excited.
Hello and welcome to KO Gaming, delivering gaming's greatest hits. Here you'll find montages of the latest video game releases, countdowns of games from both the modern day and yesteryear, as well as detailed game reviews called The Hateful Truth, by which you can judge whether or not you should put down your hard-earned money to buy a new game release. In addition, the Hits of the Week series will feature the best and worst of all the games that I've played over the course of the past 7 days. If you'd like to see some raw, unedited gameplay footage, you can check out my older gaming channel, DSP Gaming, or for some vlogging content for multiple different subjects, check out the King of Hate Vlogs. Thanks a lot for checking out KO Gaming, and I hope you enjoy your stay.
I hope you enjoy your stay. Yeah, I saw the chat mention nice watermark. How did anybody ever figure out this fucking mystery? I don't know. I paused it here. Let's take a look. How would you know this might be Darkside Phil? Aside from his name under the character on the right-hand side in the upper right-hand corner, maybe you would look at that and say, "I don't think I think I know who's playing Cammy." I'm gonna wager a guess. Maybe that's Darkside Phil, or it could be the giant fucking watermark that says DSP Gaming. He couldn't even watermark it his new channel name. That's how lazy he is. It's just DSP Gaming. Who needs to invest in a better watermark? We're gonna create a new brand. By the way, I don't think he has officially gotten the URL for his channel yet. He wants KO Gaming. I don't know if the new URL system under YouTube, which is YouTube/C/, and then once you hit a certain amount of time, you have to have your channel up for 100 days, I think. You have to have 500 subs, and then you can claim it. I don't think he's claimed it. I don't think he's been around 100 days. He has like a well, you know what? Let's take a look. Let's see how many subs does Phil, I'm sorry, does KO Gaming have? Let me go to the About section. Actually, you know what? I missed it. 1,061. Look at that. 1,061 subs. What percentage is that of his actual sub base? Because he's announced this now on Twitter, and he's announced this in a pre-stream or whatever he calls it. So he has 180,000 fucking subs on his DSP Gaming channel. And on his brand new channel, he's got a whopping 1,061. To put that into perspective, this channel that you're watching right now has 2,100 subs. And it really, it this has 20, this is nothing. This is a shit on Phil channel, and it has 2,100 subs. Whereas opposed to KO Gaming, Phil's brand new delivering content to you that you want to watch, 1,061 subs. I don't mean to toot my own horn here, but beep beep, Phil. Can you hear it? Can you hear that horn a honking? Let's take a look and see if Phil has said anything about this amazing, amazing new channel. As expected, supposed critics are already doing everything they can to bring down a new channel with no content. Valid criticism, of course. He's a little bit upset. Just a smidge. He's a smidge upset about this. I would find it funny if his new channel, if that channel trailer got pulled down from a copyright from DSP Gaming. Because you could clearly see DSP Gaming's watermark in that video. I don't know if they have permission. I think KO Gaming is robbing DSP Gaming of their content. Somebody should do something about that. That's shameful. If you missed the announcement late past night, you can find my new channel here. Leaked early, but that's okay. Now, he does talk about this. Somebody linked me to a video. I'm going to play it because it's just him snorting and honking like he always fucking does. For some reason, Phil sounds like a fucking flock of geese when he's sitting in front of a microphone. It's constantly honking and snorting like fucking waterfowl. I don't know what... I smoke a pack of cigarettes a day. I'll cough on occasion. You'll hear me get a little bit wheezy every once in a while. He doesn't smoke, so I don't understand how this works. Maybe gout affects your lungs in that man. Maybe it's more of a horrible disease than I fucking realize. I don't know. I don't know. But let's take a look at this. This is on Ardenus, I think I'm saying it right, YouTube channel. KO Gaming tries it, talking about his new channel.
All right, ladies and gents, KO Gaming, and let's talk a little bit about it, because, it got announced last night, kind of against my will. I didn't have any plans to announce it until later this weekend, or maybe early next week. Unfortunately, it leaked, because of some things with YouTube that I really don't agree with. Let's put it that way. Let me put it this way. KO Gaming is my new YouTube channel. This channel is going to be your destination source for edited gameplay, montages, my...
Your destination source. Yeah, that's where I want to go to get my hot new tips on video games. If I want to find out, is this game good? I'm going to go to KO Gaming to find out, because that's where all the hip, cool kids go. That's where the hot video gaming news is found. That's my one-stop destination for gout-related video game reviews.
Hateful Truth Reviews. Best of, worst of... kind of edited videos, countdowns, and my new series, which is going to be called Hits of the Week, where every week I'm going to take all the best and worst kind of highlight moments from all of my gameplay, and I'm going to do a video of it on that channel. So for those of you who cannot be around every single day, I can understand maybe, okay, once or twice a week I check out Phil's raw gameplay.
You know, this is an aside. This is just, what I'm going to talk about isn't just related to Phil, but I've noticed this a lot, and he does it a fucking lot. He's talking about the best and worst gameplay that he's going to put up clips of. Am I the only one that thinks that sounds really fucking arrogant? He did a series of videos where he did his top 10 funniest moments. It just seems like ego masturbation. Like, I get it. If you have a big channel or if a lot of people watch you and a fan thinks you did something funny and they put together a montage, whatever, that makes sense. But if you're doing it yourself, if you're like, oh my god, I was so funny here, I'm going to take that one, and holy shit, am I wacky over here, I'm going to take that one too and put them together, and then... put it up for everybody to see how wacky and zany I am. Just talk about jacking yourself off. And this asshole's going to make that a weekly series. The best and the worst of DSP Gaming. Put together in a montage for you to watch. Chosen by Phil. You're going to get to see what Phil really thinks is funny about him. Which, it would be like a fucking mirror into his soul.
Either live on stream or on DSP Gaming. But I don't have the time like I used to where I could watch all of his stuff. You could go to KO Gaming. And there you're going to be able to find all the stuff in edited montages that will be very time efficient. That's the word I was looking for. Okay. So.
We're only a minute 27 into this, and already we're getting from him. I'm going to, you know what, I don't have it now. I'm unprepared. I'm terrible. I know, I'm so lazy. Brightside Bob is the laziest person you'll ever meet. But I am going to implement a snorting, hacking, coughing, wheezing, gouting counter that I can put in the upper right-hand corner. So every time we watch Phil, we have a running tally of how many times he makes weird gout-related noises. That would be number one. See if you can keep track in your mind. We'll tally it up for the end of the video.
That's the deal. Now, here's the thing. I've been working on this channel for a month. No lie, I've been working on this for a month. And the channel's existed for about a month now. And I went through about a million different names for the channel. I had like so many different suggestions that I balanced around in my head. And the reason that I chose this particular name for the channel is because it could mean different things. The KO Gaming, if you didn't notice, is not KO with a period after it. It's just KO Gaming. So it could have different meanings. And we'll talk.
Is this asshole serious? I wanted to be really new age about it. You know, thinking outside of the box kind of stuff here. So I did KO Gaming, but it didn't abbreviate it. It really makes you think. It's not Knockout Gaming. What could it mean? Oh my God, give me the insight, Phil. I need to know how those little mechanisms in your mind are working. I can see the little gears turning. What surprises does this amazing, innovative, completely original, nobody else is using it on YouTube. There aren't 40,000 KO Gamings out there. But what is Phil using it for? You're gonna have to tune in to find out.
Talk about that in the future. I'm not gonna get too much into it today, but it's a flexible title. I searched and I found out that it is basically not copywritten, nor is it trademarked. So I've already got that in the works. So that's a good thing. And even though, yes, there are people on YouTube who...
He's going to copyright and trademark KO Gaming. God, please in heaven, let somebody that fucks with this idiot on a daily basis beat him to it. This is his thing. He wants KO Gaming. You can tell he's invested in the name. He thinks he's really hot shit with this name. If somebody gets that channel URL before he does, if somebody gets, I don't know, a Reddit account with it, a Tumblr account with it, an Instagram account. See, you've got to hit all the different sites. Every fucking site you can think of. Go to fucking 4chan and get the trip for fucking KO Gaming. Just everywhere. Everywhere that he could possibly go, make sure somebody has it before he does. And watch his dream collapse in on his gout-ridden ass.
Kind of go by KO Gaming. None of them are any kind of huge, you know, really renowned channel or anything where I'd be stepping on anyone's toes. It's pretty much a title that's kind of been up for grabs. A lot of people have used it, and it really hasn't taken off for anyone in a huge way. So I said this would be a good opportunity. Again, this is not KO with period, it's just KO Gaming, so it's a little different, okay? So, I've been working on this for a month. Excuse me.
Excuse me, I've got the voice of an angel.
And I've been trying to put stuff together. The good news is that, number one, the channel is partnered 100% with Machinima. It is under a managed partnership, meaning that what I upload to the channel will be protected. It won't have any issues with content ID matches or any kind of shit like that. And because it's under Machinima's banner, I get to use a lot of the resources that I've been able to use for edited content.
How angry would Phil get if you got the KO Gaming name, moniker, URL at every single social media website you can think of, and you set the page up in links to his YouTube channel and promoted it as being something that he obviously is not going for? Like KO Gaming, home of white nationalist video games. KO Gaming, pedophilic support group. And just link it back to him. Just really promote the brand in a way that really makes him proud of what he's going for. Because he'll be the asshole with the trademark and the copyright for it, but other people will be holding the social media. It could be entertaining. I don't know, that might give him a gout attack.
...in the past year, including a wide range of music, which is excellent, because I need stock music for these new edited videos I'm going to be putting out, so I'm pretty happy about that. Okay. So, ladies and gents, it'll be interesting. It's going to be an interesting experiment. Now, what happened? Because I was not ready to announce this channel yet, okay? I really wasn't. I'll be honest with everyone. I wasn't ready. What I wanted to do is I wanted to take my time, and I wanted to have like one or two videos at least up there for you guys to watch.
Yes, chat. Yeah. Somebody said Nambla's official gaming channel. My God, that would be glorious. And he's just starting out, so nobody knows anything about this channel. Anything you put out there is what it's going to be known as. If you promote it as Nambla's official gaming channel, he's got to deal with that. He's going to get all these sex offenders. Oh, that's a good review, Phil. How many little boys play this game? He won't know what the fuck's going on in the comments. It's going to mind fuck him. He won't know what to do.
to have an idea of what to expect on this new channel before it launched, right? It made sense. It makes sense to do that. Why launch a channel before there's anything on it? What doesn't make any sense? That's why I've been waiting and holding off on announcing this channel. Well, this week, as you know, I've been very sick, and I said, well, let me work on some stuff. So I've been working with a few different things. I got logos and stuff going for this channel and all of that. And quite honestly, what you're seeing on the channel right now is probably not going to be the final look of the channel. That's a very preliminary look. That's what I wanted, all right? What I wanted was to have a very unique look, something very different from the other channels, to kind of, you know, take myself out of association with them. And unfortunately, because I wasn't ready to launch this channel, I kind of got rushed into what it is, all right? So understand that what you're seeing right now for the channel, it's okay, it's certainly...
How do you get this is all, you know, he made a tweet a while back. He made a couple comments too, I think, in one of his videos talking about how much stress he's under. How terribly difficult it is to have his life. You know, there's so much pressure. He can't take a vacation. A vacation from his job of playing video games. It's really tough, you know. When I play video games, I gotta lock myself down, you know, put the ball and chain on my leg to really force myself to do it, because video games are horrible. I don't know how poor Phil deals with playing video games all day long and getting money for it. And here he is, the poor guy, under all that pressure. He can't even take a vacation. And he's been rushed into making another channel that he'll make money off of for playing video games. When the reality of when the real world finally, you know, comes back to drag Phil out of his little imagination land, and he has to get a real fucking job, and he has to actually support himself, I don't think he's going to last. I think he's going to look back and be like, holy shit, I got paid money to sit on my ass, eat fucking bacon whose grease I poured down the toilet, and I got paid to play video games. He's so oblivious to that.
Good for the launch, but it's not something that it may not look like that permanently. There may be new banners, there may be new logos, I don't know yet, all right? It's just very temporary. It was something that I was kind of rushing into just to have something there as a placeholder, okay? So anyway, yeah, this week I said, well, what I should do is I should kind of make a trailer explaining what this channel is, so that that's the first thing I want on the channel, because what I'm also going to do, I'm going to make new trailers for DSP Gaming and the King of Hate vlogs that are going to explain the methodology of those channels.
Holy shit, that's brilliant, William Simons. Kids Only Gaming. Are you fucking kidding me? This is now NAMBLA's official video game channel. Kids Only Gaming. That's what the KO stands for. It's a little bit of a surprise, just like the kid's face when he gets into the back of the van and finds out there's no candy there. That's not a candy bar, mister.
This year as well. DSP Gaming this year is going to be all raw gameplay. The King of Hate Vlogs is going to be increased vlogging about multiple topics, not just about gaming, okay? So I'm going to make trailers for those channels, too, that are going to be the highlighted videos on those channels, FYI. So, I went ahead, and I made this trailer video, and I was setting up the channel initially, so I put in, you know, related channels, which obviously are going to be my other channels, DSP Gaming, the King of Hate Vlogs, and all this. Now, there's a reason why I had to make the channel public. I'm not going to explain it here. Maybe in a few days I will, but I can't explain it right now. But I had to kind of make the channel public. And what happened was, YouTube, in all of its wisdom, decides to fucking list this channel with no content as a related channel to DSP Gaming. So as of
you could even draw art as Panda Lee as Pedo Panda. Just some weird little Asian chick that abducts children and makes them go to KO Gaming, where they don't actually play video games. It's just filled with tears and sore assholes.
Last night, I made this cool channel trailer. I uploaded it. And all of a sudden, some people started seeing this new channel, KO Gaming, as a related channel to DSP Gaming. People clicked on it and said, oh, we found it, and they leaked it all over the internet. So it is what it is. I had to do it. My hand was forced. I had to make the channel public in order to do something important that I'll talk about in a day or two here. All right? It happens, all right? What can you do? So, it's out there. And it sucks because I wasn't ready yet. People really, you know, rushed it, pushed my hand, forced my hand. It is what it is. It was going to launch within the next few days anyway. It sucks that it went live. All right?
As the flock of gout geese flies overhead and we hear their snorting for hours and hours and hours, I'm going to pause the video. I think you get the idea, though. So Phil started a new channel, and he tried to keep it super secret, and that blew up in his face because he's a fucking retard who tagged his videos with his name, put links to his shit in the video description, and then put links to his web pages on the about section of the channel. And then he's shocked that people found this out and figured it out. Phil might be a little bit retarded. Just a tad. A little retarded. So, holy shit. Somebody said they linked a montage. Let's take a look at the montage. I don't see... Oh, fuck. See, I'm doing it now. That gout is contagious. I'm already starting to hack. I'm not seeing the montage. You might be sending it to a different person. My Twitter handle is KO Gaming. So if you want me to play a video, send it to KO Gaming. That's where it would go. Now, I believe Phil is actually playing video games right now. I know it's shocking. That's not what I want. Yep, live streaming right now. That's going to be a treat. Let's watch the Grandmaster himself. Remember, if this is just too much awesome content for you, he's going to cut it up and give you a best and worst of montage for you to enjoy on his new channel, KO Gaming. Aren't you lucky motherfuckers? Oh, Grand Theft Auto. Let's see him fuck this up.
Boss, this mission is fucked up too. Dude, every mission in this game is fucked up stupid. There's no way you could reasonably do it on the first try. In fact, look, what the fuck? This is stupid as shit. The past four missions have all been fucking total bullshit.
Talk about perfect timing. You know you've entered a DSP video game stream when the first thing that greets you once you get in is the fucking words in giant bold lettering. Mission failed. So I know I'm at the right place.
Still can't buy the minigun.
Oh, I think I heard a flock of them fly by. Yep, I'm pretty sure another flock flew by.
I guess I'll buy the M4. The bike stays here now. All right.
God, that's twice now in the span of 2 minutes. Does he have fucking lung cancer? Does anybody know? Does Phil smoke? It's the only thing I can think of. I've never heard somebody who doesn't smoke cigarettes make these kind of noises at that kind of frequency. It's all the fucking time. Is he dying of lung cancer?
What the cop took me out! What the hell was that?
Don't push me.
The cop, look at this! I got a 1-star water level because the cop, what the fuck?
Oh, that's the second time now. So far, we've had gout geese twice and mission failed twice. Brilliant. What is that? The police want to stop me from shooting people and driving the wrong way down the road. What? I know, it's mind-blowing. In a game called Grand Theft Auto, the police would stop, would be an obstacle for you. Who saw that coming?
Fucking terrible. Wow, it is definitely the worst fucking Grand Theft Auto game of all of them. It's not a bad game, it's just really sad how fucking just broken the game is. Yes, the cop hits me while I'm on a bike. Yeah, I get the 1-star wanted level and I get arrested. What the fuck?
I was just minding my business, driving down the wrong side of the road, and I kind of hit a cop with my motorcycle. And then he gets all uppity about it, and he arrests me. I mean, come on. Haven't you run somebody over before? It's not that big a deal.
GTA. Oh, Oh, what's with this car? Look at this. I didn't even do anything. It just started fucking wiling out on the road. Wow, he's a sexy bastard. We heard that first.
Is this really the shit people tune in to watch? Like, I've watched enough of his streams by this point to know that he gives horrible commentary. There are moments, you can count them out, where it'll be 2, 3, 4, even 5 minutes, where he doesn't say shit, aside from honking and snorting and coughing. And, no commentary, no, not talking about the game, the mechanics, the history of the game. He could fill it with anything. Instead, we get him whining because he ran over a police officer, and the police officer didn't take that kindly. And then talking about bugged driving mechanics. Let's watch him fuck this one up.
I hit him! What the fuck? I hit him with the car. It didn't count. Come on. This is a joke. Oh my god, I couldn't get him out of the...
What? Come on now. Bug dry. I told you. That's exactly what was going to happen, and it fucking happened exactly that way. He fucked up. Bug driving mechanics. Look at this dumb motherfucker. Yeah, get out of your car, Phil. Chase him on foot. That's going to work out really well for you. Wow, is he dumb.
Look at this.
Beautiful. Fucking exactly what I expected.
This is trash. So bad. So the worst GTA there is. Man.
He must have stage 4 emphysema. All I hear in the background is bug driving mechanics. Phil, your car's beat to shit. It's raining outside. Get on a different fucking vehicle. Pick something else. Maybe it'll handle a little better. That would be the problem solving you'd think somebody who plays video games as much as you do would be able to exercise. That's something that they should be able to dig down deep for and figure out. But no, it's not his fault. Clearly, it's Grand Theft Auto's fault. Clearly, this video game is out to get him. The programmers are out to get him. Oh, here, yep, beautiful. Let's see his amazing commentary.
It's the fucking really glitchy fucking bullshit missions. Ugh.
Hey, get on the streets. Get online. Every yard. I miss my mom the most, though. God, she's hot. Almost as hot as the chicks in the video for this next song.
Well, 10th time's a charm, right?
Here we go again.
Bad news, Tony!
What the fuck? Yes!
Come on, now.
Because I wasn't turning.
He's got to intentionally be playing this badly. I'm having a lot of trouble believing he's this terrible. That's right, Chad. He gets over $1,000 dues on his Patreon to show you A+ gameplay like this. He's just so goddamn terrible at video games. How is one man this bad at video games? He's not that old. He can't claim that it's his reflexes that have given out. It's not like he's brand new to gaming, like he's never played a video game before. He's played for years. He was the Super Street Fighter EX Plus 10 limited edition Super Nintendo champion. Okay, I don't know if you know that, but he's hot shit at that particular game when it comes to tournament-level play. And yet, this asshole, look at this motherfucker, just running into shit everywhere, doesn't know what the fuck he's doing.
What the fuck? This is a joke. This is a fucking joke! Thank you!
You know, his stream is a really good example. You know how most people bitch about modern video games holding your hand? They're fucking mini markers everywhere now. They don't let you explore because they think you're so retarded you need to have your hand held at every single moment. He's the reason why. This asshole is the guy that developers run into when they do testing groups. He's the guy that's sitting there with a controller in hand saying, "This is fucking, this is too tough. This is too tough. Why do I need to drive the vehicle? Can the vehicle drive me? This is difficult." This is a motherfucker that has made video games regress to the point where they're not even really games anymore. They play themselves. They're animated movies that you kind of sit back and watch. That's probably why Let's Plays are so fucking popular now. Because you're watching it anyway. You're not really playing shit. Look at this guy. He is dumb as pitch. Mission failed. Again and again. He can't do this. It's fucking GTA. It's not even a hard mission. It's not like he's flying that RC plane now, is it? This is some basic shit, and he has failed at this repeatedly now.
Ones I've played. My God.
No fucking bullshit. This is the seventh time he's done this mission. Seven fucking times. Seven times in a row to do something that a 10-year-old could do. And he is struggling this fucking much with it. He's falling off his bike. He's running into walls. He can't shoot anybody because he doesn't have any weapons. Look at this shit. And then he's like, why do I have a wanted level? Maybe because you're running over 40 fucking people, you dumb sack of pig shit.
Shut up. I'm so pissed. I don't want to hear any fucking radio.
That's right. He likes to sulk in silence. So we'll be able to hear his tears without the soundtrack getting in the way when he fucks this up for the eighth time. Yeah, that's good, Phil. Just park it there.
There. Holy shit.
You know, and what kind of fucking standards does Panda Lee have? This is the man that she gets on top of to make love to. Like this worthless sack of gout-ridden shit who can't play a video game to save his life. That's what gets her pussy wet? What kind of hellscape was she living in? Did she come from a gulag where he looked like a good choice? Like, how does she reconcile the reality of this fat fuck with what she imagined he really was?
Wow! Wow, that was great! That was totally fucking legit! What am I supposed to do here? I'm gonna miss the next exchange.
What am I supposed to do? I don't know. Does a giant red fucking arrow clue you into maybe what you need to do?
Look, he's still driving. He won't stop. My God, this is an impossible mission.
Bugged mission mechanics. Come on now. How am I supposed to play the game if it won't let me win?
Well, what am I gonna do? I missed it. There's no way I can get over there. Fuck this game. This is the dumbest shit ever.
He is so fucking
ever.
salty. So salty right now. This is number eight. He's gonna fuck up number eight.
What the fuck?
Come on now. Why are these buildings getting in the way? That's not how it works in real life. Oh, please explode. Please explode. Please explode. Come on. Come on. Fuck. Oh, I got him. What a dumb motherfucker. I got it. No. Yeah.
Past my own broken fucking thing.
Oh, hey, at least you got a gun, you stupid shit. Why don't you put the barrel in your mouth and just end it now? It's not gonna happen. Just put the... pull the trigger. Oh! What a dumb sack of fucking shit. Oh, my God. This guy. This fucking retard. This is number 8 now. He's on number fucking 8. He's fucked up so many times in a row. How does he do that? He got stuck on the taxi cab, it explodes, and then when he finally gets over it and he's running into the street, he gets run over by the guy he's supposed to stop. How do you fuck up that hard?
Bad news, Tony. Don't make me lose my shit, pal.
Bad news, Tony, you're stuck in the worst GTA. You're fucked. You can't even get a vehicle.
Is anyone amazed by the fact that this dumb asshole is having difficulties completing these missions? He has no weapons. He keeps getting arrested and dying and failing the mission. He's got his fists. He has nothing else, from what I understand. And then he can't figure out why he can't stop anybody. Go get some fucking guns before you start a mission, Phil. Go get, some support. Get yourself ready. You know, prepare a little bit. Just a tiny bit. Oh, beautiful. Just beautiful. He can't even drive down a straight road. The road is straight, and he somehow fucked that up. God help him if he runs into a curve somewhere. Is he going to handle this? Right into the wall, maybe? Maybe Panda Lee took over for him.
My first time experience. I still hit him with the fucking bike. That's hilarious. Alright, now this next guy would be fucking amazing like...
So how's he gonna fuck this up, chat? Place your bets now. Is he gonna run into a wall, get run over by the people he's trying to track down, I don't know, get beaten to death, maybe he'll get arrested, maybe a car will explode. So place your bets. How is he gonna fuck up attempt number 8?
What the fuck?
We need some Benny Hill music for this shit.
What the fuck? This is a fucking cruel joke. Look at this! I can't target the guy! I can't target him and hit him, because he's running in circles, and the game's controls are terrible. Look, there's no way to catch him. You missed the third exchange. No, the game sucks.
If I were you, I'd start playing.
There's no way I'm going to catch up for the next exchange. There's no fucking way.
So, let's bet early now, because he's already fucked this one up. What do you think's going to stop him on attempt number 9? What's gonna fuck him up after he fails this one? Because it's guaranteed he's going to fail this next one. It's remarkable to me that he is this fucking bad. Look at this shit. It's like somebody's grandmother's driving the car. I can't see over the steering wheel.
What the fuck? Did you see that? You won't die! Please, Lord, let that be it. Yes! Oh my God.
Holy shit. So it only took him 8 times to beat that mission. I stand corrected. Don't I look foolish with egg on my face? You know, 8 fucking attempts. at the easiest mission that you could possibly engage in. Yeah, do I want that sword? Maybe I'll go take that sword. He'll probably trip and fall on it and cut his fucking head off, because that's Phil. Let's watch him do that. Ah, these are glitched curb mechanics. I'm running around with a katana and I fall and I decapitate my. What is that?
Tony, it's Donald. I have a rather pressing matter that requires your particular skills. Please call me at my office as soon as you can.
All right. Whew. He wants me to go back, but I'm saving my game first. Because I am not doing this fucking shit again. No way am I doing that mission again. And I got a little bit of money, so maybe I can hit my ammunition and at least buy something.
It's really depressing. The one thing that really annoys me a lot about Phil, aside from him being terrible at video games, is watching him butcher video games that I actually like or enjoy. Now, I haven't played Liberty City Stories, so maybe it is an enormous pile of shit. But the GTA games are fun, so when I watch him flail around like a retard, constantly failing and bitching about mechanics and, you know, just the way the game world is structured and laid out, it annoys me, because I know those, you know, criticisms that he has are bullshit. It's just complete fictitious bullshit. And he still bitches about it. He gets paid for this. Wrap your fucking head around that. People pay him money to be this terrible at video games and to give his bullshit opinion on whether you should buy something or not. How fucking ludicrous is that? Somebody in chat said the music in this particular game is copyrighted. I hope that's true. I don't give a shit about this channel, but I know Phil cares about TSP Gaming. So if he's streaming all these games and all the music that we hear playing is copyrighted, he's going to flip his fucking shit.
All right. Phew. Let's get some health. Maybe I'll change my outfit. I've been wearing this outfit for quite some time now. What do we want to wear?
Of course he was wearing casual clothes to match his casual gameplay style. Why am I not surprised by that? That outfit is Phil incarnate. Why would he change that? He should wear that in real life. He's a fucking casual. That's what Phil is. Oh, yeah, enjoy the dead silence. Good commentary, Phil.
Okay,
all right. Hey now. Award-winning commentary. Totally worth the $1,200.
The last, considering there's no other missions here. I'll take the bike.
Cork. Sniff the contents and look instantly civilized. It's the wine that merges sophistication and nuance.
She's
with complex
gone.
And satisfying
She's
results.
Gone.
You know what? I want to check something. Phil currently has 378 people watching. This stream that lets people comment on his shitty video game playing abilities has 472 people watching. So, for the very, you know, from the very basic standpoint of economics, wouldn't it make more sense for Phil to allow people to talk openly and say whatever the fuck they want? Wouldn't he get more viewers doing that? So he hurts his own bottom line because he's so super sensitive. He can't handle the banter in a comment section he doesn't even have to look at. Dumb motherfucker.
All right, Love on the Rocks.
Tony, you've got to help me. O'Donovan's got evidence linking me to Salvatore. We're sunk.
Calm down. Evidence goes missing every day. Not to mention judges, witnesses.
All right, this is depressing, watching him play video games. I'm going to take a look, see if that... Somebody said they wanted to send a montage video of his amazing video game abilities. So let's see if that Gout Theft Auto, that works. Gout Theft Auto, that's what he should name it. Honk Honk Sniff. That's a quote from one of Phil's amazing streams, obviously. What is this? DSP tries it, excessive racism. You know what? Let's go for it.
He's fucking black. Help, he's black. You know when he's black, there's gonna be trouble. What the hell?
Ow. He shot the fucking handcuffs. Now what? Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Get out of there, Jaden. Come on, go, go, go.
Jaden.
Oh, come on, asshole. Don't get your lick squished. You don't want to be like fucking... What's his name? What the hell's the guy who was Superman? I forget his name. Christopher Reeve.
Oh, jeez. Bad joke, Phil.
I know.
That's terrible.
Christopher Reeve jokes are always funny.
It's
what are you talking about?
It's okay because he's dead.
All right, nigga. It's time.
In China, they say, rashness brings success to few.
In China, they say, Chicky Chang Wang Charlie Chan Chicka Chaka Chaka Cha.
Shut the fuck up.
He's not even good at racial humor. If he was funny, it'd be one thing, but it's everything with Phil I've noticed is like base. It's just the lowest common denominator. He puts out the comment there thinking that itself will get the humor. Oh, I said nigger. Is everybody going to laugh? Oh, nobody? Nobody? Phil is terrible at comedic timing. Phil is terrible at telling jokes. Phil is just terrible all around. It's remarkable that he's this bad at everything he fucking attempts. This is why I wish he would have done the political videos he was hinting that he might be doing, and now we'll never see them.
Yes, Jews in space, you'll see what happens. Aha! Oh yes! Fuck you! That's you, fight me now, Jew! You have no legs. Give me your money. You've hoarded it for far too long. Why are you carrying your balls next to you? You stupid moron. You big-nosed freak.
He's just so unfunny. It's remarkable how bad he is even at these jokes. He could have put some names out there, you know, Shlomo, Goldenstein, talked about shekels. He could have put on the asthma voice. Oh, my asthma. He could have done anything. But it's just, Jew. That's the joke, the setup, and the punchline. Jew. I'm going to stomp on you. Jew. Isn't there a backstory to this? I vaguely remember that he got in some kind of trouble with Twitch or YouTube or something for one of the streams where he was talking a bunch of shit, essentially, and somebody reported him. And then he had to go and he went and made a rant video. Am I thinking of somebody else or is this him? DSP is red-pilled. He's one of the most red-pilled motherfuckers on the internet. Move over, Mundane Matt. You've got competition in town.
Haha, Isaac Heimler. That's my name. Fuck you. Aha. And now, turn the ovens on.
Oh, okay. Yeah, somebody said in chat, Blip TV, is that what it got him kicked off of? I remember he got banned from somewhere. This got him banned from Blip TV. God, he shoots himself in the foot so much, doesn't he? Blip TV, he fucked up the thing with Twitch TV, now he's fucking up the thing with YouTube. I kind of suspect the reason he's doing the secondary channel is he's scared shitless DSP Gaming is going to go under, either through copyright or community strikes or something. I don't know exactly what, but he's terrified. And once he loses YouTube, he has nothing else. There's no other platform he can go to. That's it. Everybody else has kicked his ass off of them, or he's thrown a tantrum to the point of where he can't support himself. What, is he going to host the videos himself? He's so inept. You've seen him play video games. I don't know how he manages a website to begin with.
Look at this elevator. It's all colored and just a special elevator. It's for the priest only. It takes you to special quarters with his room full of boys. Where are they? I know you're hiding them. This is a long-ass elevator. Oh, hello. It's quite rude of you. Quite rude of you. Leave it to a Jew to drop in uninvited.
Oh, this should be entertaining. Let me guess, he honks and snorts at him.
The only 28-year-old that has found themselves laid off from their jobs and in financial straits, but instead of sucking up his pride and taking a crappy job and moving back in with his parents, he has decided to panhandle his fan base. The relationship that DSP has with the fans is now totally based on money, and I fail to see how such a situation can end any way but badly. Save your pennies for your personal rainy days ahead and force Phil to be accountable for himself. Holy shit. This guy fucking is so jealous of my popularity and the fact that for 4 or 5 months now, yeah, I've been able to turn this into a business per se and been able to support myself, that he is fucking reporting me falsely to websites to try to get me banned and fuck me over so I have to stop doing this for a living. Wow. You are a shithead.
Wow. I want to hear that again.
So jealous of my popularity.
His popularity. Let's go take a look at his popularity. He's got 400 people watching him on a channel that has 180,000 subs. That's his popularity. His brand new gaming channel, which, based on an account like this, it should have at the very least 10,000 people subscribed to it right now, since he announced it 24 hours ago, has about 1,000. 1,000 people subscribed to it. So it's funny hearing him say, where is it? Let me back it up.
Is so jealous of my popularity.
What popularity? There are people that do fucking streams about My Little Pony that pull in more people than you, Phil. There are channels dedicated to shitty DeviantArt drawing skills that have more subscribers than your new channel has. What popularity are you talking about? You suckered 138 people to give you money on Patreon. There are a lot of people out there that make money on Patreon that actually put out good content, and it makes sense they're supported. Somehow you've bamboozled these idiots, these fucking Aspergered autists, to give you money to do the dumb shit that you do. But don't mistake that small fan base, that, zealot-like following, as popularity, because it sure as shit ain't from where I'm sitting, with your 400 people on a live stream, and your new channel sitting at 1,000 fucking subs.
And the fact that for 4 or 5 months, I fucking is so jealous.
What? It's just a fucking egomaniac. What an egomaniac. Yeah, right now on this dumb fucking bullshit stream where I'm not selling you anything, 489 viewers. On his shitty pay me Patreon dollary dues, 402 people watching. So, bravo, Phil. Way to capitalize on that marketplace. Your astounding popularity has really netted you a lot of money, I can see. You're rolling in the big bucks. Is a big money guy. I mean, with stellar commentary like that, you know, dead fucking silence. It's no wonder that he's so popular as a Let's Player in the community. It makes perfect sense. Let's see if anybody sent any other montage. Sorry, Bob, but DSP Gaming is safe from copyright strikes. Mama Machinima saves his fat ass. Well, that is sad. That is depressing. Making fun of autistic people. Is he looking in a mirror when he filmed this video? Let's take a look.
Kojima World Order. I don't just fucking make fun of others. To be ridiculing people and making fun of them, I mean, it's not what I want to do. PlayStation doesn't allow you to easily do stuff like this like the Xbox does, because the PlayStation was designed for fucking autistic people. I don't know what they were thinking. Because the PlayStation doesn't allow you to easily do stuff like this like the Xbox does, because the PlayStation was designed for fucking autistic people.
Well, I can't disagree with that statement. I mean, Phil does play a lot of PlayStation games, so maybe that's what he's saying. Maybe he's saying, I play the PlayStation so much, so clearly it's designed for autistic people. Because I can barely not shit myself just sitting here. That takes a lot of willpower on my part as Darkseid Phil, in between my geese honking and snorting because of my terrible gout affliction. You know, it really drains the energy out of you. It's really hard not to crap myself. I am severely autistic. My name is Darkseid Phil, and I prefer the PlayStation. I think that's what he was going for with this particular video. That's my guess. DSP Christmas special. Oh, happy holidays. Does he try to get his fat ass down the chimney and then get stuck and they have to fucking bring in a bulldozer or a backhoe and knock down the bricks from his brand new house to get him out? Maybe Panda Lee takes a ladder up to the roof and just drowns his fat ass in Crisco butter. Let's take a look.
Hello, little girls and boys. Santa Claus here, fresh off of delivering toys all around the world, appearing in one of DSP's videos for the first time in a long time, to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. So without further ado, let's get started with the Christmas special for 2015, The 12 Things That This Year Really Were a Bitch. Hit it.
The first thing that this year really was a bitch, the order was a bait and switch.
Nope, done. I'm not watching this. This is shit. Does he do this every year? He can't sing for 7 minutes, right?
Great, more skins. Glitching out the stage.
Ooh, pachinko machines.
Huge rip-off game.
Holy fuck, he really does sing for 7 minutes. No, yeah, I'm bouncing out early on this one. Even I'm not going to withstand the pain of that shit. Now, what do we got here from Pixel Buster? DSP tries at bullying. You can't... How is DSP bullying anybody? Could you imagine him starting shit with some fucking preteen? Talking shit to, like, some 8-year-old? All the 8-year-old has to do is say, at least I don't have to take 7 fucking attempts at a mission in GTA Liberty City Stories before I succeed, you dumb, fat, gout-ridden motherfucker.
And I can have this cool stuff going on. And then I go there and all I see, thumbs down, fuck Phil. Phil hates his fans. Listen to Chris. Chris knows what he's talking about. Fuck you, fuck you. And I'm like, that's it. That's the last fucking straw. I'm not going to put up with this bullying bullshit anymore from someone who's made it his personal agenda to hate on me, to fucking push his views and get his popularity to skyrocket. Chris Furtado is nothing but a bully.
DSP tries it.
Bullying isn't always about physicality.
Often, it starts with a joke.
Teasing someone for being different.
Get a fucking life. This fucker's played 1,000 fucking matches. Are you kidding me? What a fucking loser.
See, I can't call this bullying. I can't even call it banter, because didn't he get his ass handed to him? If I remember this video, he bitches about how much this guy played, and then this guy mops the fucking floor with his ass, doesn't he?
Seriously. Look at this douche. He's wearing a fucking... Look at that scarf he's wearing over a jacket indoors playing a song. What a fucking loser. You stupid, yuppie piece of crap. Look at this guy.
And in the age of Facebook and Twitter, sometimes there can be no escape.
I was I'm reading the chat. People are saying, yeah, he got wrecked. Okay, that is the video I'm thinking of. The one where he tries shit-talking and then gets his ass beat into the dirt. I'm watching this. It's okay. It's Phil talking shit and then looking like an idiot. But I wouldn't call it bullying. Phil can't really bully anybody. He's terrible at banter. I've watched videos where he's tried to shit-talk people he was playing in competitive video games, and he always loses. I mean... There has to be a certain arrogance, or at least ability level, to bully somebody. You can't really shit-talk and then lose horribly. It's like saying, DSP, he's not a bully, because he'd be like the guy that walks up to somebody and says, let's fight, motherfucker, I'm gonna kick your ass, I'm a tough guy, and then with one punch is on the ground crying and rocking back and forth, making honking sounds. That's DSP. He can't be a bully. It's physically impossible for DSP to bully any other human being. I've got 2 links to this. Apparently that was a popular one. I've seen people bring up his t-shirts. They keep sending me to whatever the fuck this is. Hate Army 86. Nothing. What the fuck is this? These are the laziest t-shirts. Really? Nothing I could do. This isn't real, is it? How much is he charging for this? Reserve it now? $18 fucking? Are you kidding me? $18. He did that. That's nothing but... Does anybody buy this? Nobody buys this, right? Like, you know, the DSP thong, maybe, because they want his face on their ass. I don't know. But this? This shitty fucking Photoshopped, put in some Arial text and call it a day? Nothing I could do. That's all it's... That describes the shirt. That's... He just gave up. He's telling the person buying this piece of crap for $18. Nothing I could do. This is as good as I am at making fucking t-shirts. Give me $18. I can't even imagine what the shipping is. Fuck that. Fuck Phil. What an idiot. What a lazy fucking idiot. At least make your shirts appealing. Holy fuck. Yep, just checked it out. Giant tits, always nice. Committing a federal offense. Now that sounds like it could be interesting.
Further to the website, and it says, no, it was left in your mailbox. Now, here at my facility where I live, this private, it's not a facility, it's a private community, our mailboxes are way at the front. So Leanna and I, after dinner, we go for a walk, we walk to the front of the facility, open the box, nothing. So this is the second time this has happened in 3 months. The United States Postal Service has lied online on their own tracking information and to Amazon.com. They lied and said they delivered something they didn't. It's actually against the law because mail that goes through the United States Postal Service is federal. It's protected by the federal government. If you open up someone's mail, if you steal someone's mail, it's considered a federal offense. And so the United States...
past 6 months that we've lived here, we've still been getting mail for the people who used to live here. We're not supposed to be. They should have changed their addresses, but they forgot in a few cases to change their mailing address for a few companies. One of the companies, the federal government wrote them, the IRS, and said, your business, your car business, or whatever the hell business it was that they were operating out of here, you haven't filed taxes on this business in over 2 years. So we're hoping you really didn't make any income on this business, because if you did, you owe us massive back taxes and we're going to come after you. It's basically what the mailing said. Now, good news is that's none of my business. It has nothing to do with me, so I can just ignore it.
Wait, so he opened somebody else's mail from the IRS, and now he's doing a video talking about it? That's brilliant, Phil. That's not going to come to bite you in the ass one day. Wow, he's dumb.
Well, again, it made me question. I wonder what kind of a business were they operating out of here that for over 2 years now, you know, because they just moved earlier this year, they didn't even file taxes.
By the federal government, if you open up someone's mail, if you steal someone's mail, it's considered a federal offense.
You know, his house, everybody knows what his address is. You could look at the selling records for it to find out who the previous owner was. I wonder what their reaction would be to the fact that some dumb fat fuck opened up their mail and then read out their personal business about their private fucking business to the internet. That's kind of remarkable, really, that Phil would set himself up like that. GG, good job. Yeah, that's smart thinking, Phil. Double perfect or perfect? Oh, yeah, I remember this. I'll play this. It's good.
Wow, what a great opponent I have for my final match of the night, Wonder Waffle 407. I'm sure he's been looking forward to this with his Wonder Waffles. Almost 12,000 point bison. See how he does.
Who will come out on top? Mike.
What the hell? Fuck you. He's horrible. He is terrible. Absolutely awful.
See, this goes back to what I was talking about with bullying. Now, for Phil to even be, you know, considered for the title of bullying, he would have to shit talk and banter and hunt this guy down and do this repeatedly. But you're about to see why Phil can never ever be a bully and why he's terrible at banter. So he shit talks after one round. Let's look at the immediate fucking response to that.
I love it. Online play. Only the shitty may apply.
Fight.
Can't do anything. I was pressing buttons. I was actually trying to throw, so I didn't get a tech and I didn't get a fucking throw. I got nothing. The entire round was because I couldn't fucking do any moves online. Wow, dude. He didn't get one legitimate hit. Can't block. Tried to block, he jumped back. Look at this, I can't do anything. I'm not doing anything, I'm just getting hit. I'm blocking, oh my god. I did absolutely nothing half that time and still got hit.
So let me understand what he just said there. I did absolutely nothing and still got hit. What was he expecting was going to happen? That he's going to stand still in a fighting game and not take damage? Is he fucking retarded? I'm pressing buttons, I'm pushing buttons, and I'm still getting hit. Maybe if I'll just stand here and not do anything, maybe that'll change the game mechanics. Maybe I'll be impervious to injuries. Promoting a profiting off of David Bowie's death. Pissing off people for shit. What is this? Alright, let's take a look.
Hadouken!
What?
Surprise, motherfucker.
I feel like I'm watching a Naruto AMV from the fucking early internet. Why are all these DSP montages? Why do they have the soundtrack? Like, I keep expecting Linkin Park to kick in and then some Bleach animation to be thrown in with some edgy fucking Adobe splashes. Maybe a few explosions. I'm not sure. But I wouldn't be surprised that he is trying to profit off of somebody's death. That would not surprise me in the least. What do we got? Revealing and threatening be who? Yeah. Be awesome one.
It's like, come on, man.
So, yeah, I know. They came out with a new DLC, Criminals and what, Gaylords or something?
Be awesome one's tears sustain me. Sending me awesome hate one. Messages now.
He's sending you hate messages. Fine. Are you serious?
Right. Yeah, he's like, oh, stop sucking Phil's dick.
Wow.
Your tears sustain me, awesome one.
Yeah, how you doing, be awesome one over in Europe? How you doing? I have your name and address, so, you know, any day that I feel like making a trip across the pond, I'll come see you. It's really smart doing those false copyright claims against me and giving me your IP on my website. It was very smart.
I'm so very angry at you right now. I totally know who you are, but I haven't done anything yet. I want you to live with the threat of me being able to do something, rather than me retaliating after you fucked with me for months on end. That's very believable, Phil. I'm sure he's terrified right now. Phil's going to hop on a plane, if they can load him into one. They'll need a hazmat unit working that plane with his gout infection, before he can fly internationally, of course. I'm sure there's some kind of prohibition against him going across the pond in his medical condition. But yeah, he's going to track him down, teach him a lesson. He just wants him to know that. I could get you any time. Just chew on that. Darkside Phil here. I want to put the terror of God into you. Bugged? Okay, how do you fuck up unboxing? Does he find a way? Let's find out.
It's time for another good idea, bad idea. Good idea.
And let's open it for the first time. Ooh, voila! Alright, so we do have the disc.
Bad idea.
Okay, what is up, everybody? Darkside Phil here, and welcome to Release Day Unboxing for Tuesday.
Jesus, is he filming this in fucking Silent Hill? You hear that fucking siren in the background? Is it like a wind tunnel in his fucking house? Nice audio, Phil. God, my audio's shit, and it still sounds better.
February 11th. 2014, and before everyone says what on earth is going on, you probably hear an incredibly annoying, high-pitched droning sound going on. That is the fire alarm in my condo facility.
And the problem is...
The problem is, there is no problem. The perfect time to film a video is when you have a fucking high-pitched siren going off in the background. The audience loves it. People with headphones always tell me, hey, Phil, could you put in more loud, irritating sounds that deafen me in one of my ears? And I'm like, I can totally do that. I've got to unbox Lightning Returns. You're in for a treat.
The fire alarm in this condo facility has a nasty habit of, during the middle of the winter, especially when it's very cold, of going off as a malfunction. Now, this is actually a common problem with older fire, fire detection systems. And, of course, this building is old, and they don't feel like ever replacing it or upgrading it because the condo association is a bunch of cheapskate motherfuckers. So this alarm has gone off no less than 3 times already today. It actually went off once when I was out picking up Final Fantasy 13.
Shut up and get to the point!
Let's go through the unboxing. Hell, there may even be a chance that the fire alarm gets turned off during the unboxing. Who knows? And then we'll talk about how we're going to handle today, because today is a special day in regards to gameplay. All right, so...
How does somebody stand there, film a video, and hear that shit in the background, and keep doing it? Why wouldn't they wait 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes for it to stop? Nobody was so desperate for an unboxing of fucking Lightning Returns that he had to get this shit out as quickly as possible. He's so fucking lazy. It's like, whatever, who cares? Oh, the camera stopped working and there's nothing on screen, whatever. The sound of my amazing voice will comfort them. And, you know, the constant screeching of the fucking hellscape alarm going off in the background.
Lightning Returns, Final Fantasy 13. You might be saying, what the fuck, really? A lot of people are saying that right now. They're like, really? This game exists? You're telling me that this game is a third installment in the Final Fantasy 13 series. That's right. And, you know, it's funny.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
1 hour later. 2 hours later.
Somebody in chat, if it's crap, why are you showing it? Well, because the stream highlights shit like this. That's the point of it. Here's a better question for you. Why are 523 people watching this and, only 57 sitting on his fucking channel right now? I don't know. Maybe there's more entertainment value in watching Phil fuck up and go down in flames than there is in watching Phil just do his day-to-day gerbil-like routine.
3 hours later.
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time cards.
Doesn't really matter. There's no real advantage to buying it on either other console, okay? So it says here, it all ends here. Doomsday results in a different journey for every player. Real-time battles empower your every move. Hundreds of game-changing weapons and outfit combinations. So there you go. No online play, nothing like that. I'm sure, don't worry. Oh yeah, game content download. I'm sure there's going to be DLC for it. Don't worry. I'm sure it's coming. Because the game probably doesn't have an ending, just like Part 2, and you probably have to pay for the real ending later on. But I digress. So now, unfortunately, let's talk about reality. As you can hear, the alarm has not stopped fucking ringing. And it's actually funny, because I'm going to show you guys something.
It's not funny. I'm going to go deaf in my left ear. I've got headphones on. So I'm going to skip ahead towards the end, like people said, and let's see the grand finale of this.
Don't worry, I am having much headway in regards to that. And that's it. So thanks for watching the noisiest, most probably annoying release day unboxing you've ever watched. And hopefully this will get fixed and we'll have gameplay today. I'll have to let you know on Twitter. Thanks, everybody.
Wait, so he doesn't actually unbox it? Why is it an unboxing video? What was the point of this then? He's showing you what it looks like? This is a let's look at the box video? With fucking fire alarms in the background? People pay, he makes $1,200 to do what you just watched. That's, God fucking damn. People are retarded. People on the internet are retarded to pay for this. Neighbor tells him to shut up. That sounds like it would be entertaining.
I can't die like this. I can't die like this. I always picture myself dying, having a threesome with Nicole Richie and Paris Hilton.
You gotta make it happen, Spider-Man!
Shut the fuck up!
Another fight, huh?
The more the merrier.
See, everyone wanted me to play Mafia too. This is the same shit, right?
And some for you.
Oh, yeah, and some for you. And for you too. How about for you? I don't want to grab him. I never tried to grab him. What the fuck? Whirlwind punch! Whirlwind punch! Whirly wind! Spinning wind attack of the wind fist wind! I can't stop fucking attacking, look. I'm just gonna keep walking forward, see? And swinging my fist around, see? And if you get in the way, it's your own fault, see? Why you guys gotta pick on me? Don't you have some prohibition gig to run?
That's all she wrote.
I thought that went rather well. More like
this. Oh boy.
Say uncle.
Hey, shut up.
Come on, what do you got? Tiny, that was tricks. Come on, where you go?
God, he's that guy, isn't he? This was at the duplex he lived at, or the apartment? He's that guy that won't shut up at 3 in the morning. And everybody fucking hates, isn't he? That's lovely. That's good stuff. I could imagine everybody on his floor just loves him. Alright, let's see. I don't know what these are. If I'm going to watch something, it's going to have Phil in it. I don't know. I'm not sure what that was. Is this more of him getting his shit kicked in?
Quan Chi. Now, Quan Chi got nerfed. I wonder if this guy knows that Quan Chi got nerfed with this patch. His summoner mode has been nerfed. I guess there was some issues with Quan Chi.
Was it Dark Type Bill?
Oh my god.
Oh fuck, I remember this. This is good.
Alright, let's play. Hopefully this guy...
why'd you mute...
Oh my god, we already have an idiot. I'm gonna play him though. It's okay, I'm gonna play this guy. Yeah, how'd you mute that guy? Oh, why'd you do that?
Oh man.
Alright, let's play this guy. And then I'll mute the mic. Why'd you mute that guy?
Plug your mic in.
First match is gonna be a train wreck. I can already tell. Some idiot. Wow! Oh my god, this outfit is disgustingly ugly! Dude, look at how ugly this shit is! Are you kidding me? Hideous. What a hideous outfit. I can't even get over how ugly the outfit is. Okay, no block, great. I was holding block, but okay. Well, he got me with a combo.
Wow! Wow!
Listen to this idiot!
Oh my god! I can't believe
unflippable, unblockable. Why can't I block it? Oh my. Oh my god, why can't
I even do a move. I can't teleport. I can't do anything.
Oh my god! Why can't I block you? Oh my god! Online play, only the kitty can apply.
Oh yeah!
You drop your combo! You're terrible! You are awful! Get out of my face!
Oh my god!
Can you teleport some more?
What?
Oh no!
Oh my god, what a fucking idiot.
No, for real though, why don't you be fucking liking talking to people you party? What a shit talker. Honestly. So bad. So bad.
You know, he's just mashing buttons and he's hitting combos because I can't do anything.
So bad.
What a fucking idiot.
Oh, yeah, I dropped the combo. What will I do? Online combo.
Oh, my God.
Yo, your girlfriend's an idiot.
Look at this guy. Now he's going to insult my girlfriend, but he says, what a fucking loser.
You're fucking awful.
What a fucking loser.
Now look at my skeleton.
Wow. I actually have to upload this video.
Stop playing video games, you're terrible!
I have to upload this video to show the level of intelligence of the common person playing this fucking game. What a fucking idiot.
He got a shit wrecked. Beautiful. Why is it every video that I see of him playing games online, he's always getting his shit kicked in? I love it when people get through, too. It's really obvious that Phil engages quite a bit in muting. And just silencing anybody he plays against. Because I think at this point he knows that if he lets anybody in and he doesn't control the volume and he lets them speak, it's going to end disastrously. He's going to run into this and look like a fucking retard on his own channel. That is fantastic.
What a complete fucking idiot. Seriously. What a complete idiot. And this is why you need to disable your mics online. He's a complete terrible player. No, the netcode, by the way, was not any better. It was delayed. This is why he was getting hits on me. He was just mashing out his bullshit, and I wasn't able to block or move out of it.
You know, if the netcode's so terrible, he brings this up a lot. You know, online lag. But if that's true, if you're playing a game and the netcode is terrible, why does that automatically make your opponent have an advantage? Wouldn't it be bad for them, too? So what you're saying is you both had to deal with terrible netcode, and he still kicked your fucking ass.
Fucking idiot, a stupid little kid, a stupid little child. I mean, like, if I didn't upload this match, it would be a disservice to everyone who actually has intelligence. You know, this is the common person who plays these fucking games. Oh my god, like, you know what the fuck. So let's just I actually have to recap. What did he say? Let's see. He insults about muting people when I play online. He insults my girlfriend. He insults the shitty netcode of the game, which is garbage. He didn't even do one impressive combo. The guy is obviously a fucking mentally ill idiot.
Why would he care if it impressed you or not? Your ass was on the ground. He was the one that won. You saw his skeletons, right, Phil? I mean, he told you to take a look because he was the victor. That's what you were looking at. They weren't impressive enough combos for you. Motherfucker, you lost. They were impressive enough to beat your ass.
Yeah, I mean, what the fuck? Everyone in the stream chat's agreeing with me. They're saying, that guy needs fucking mental help. Like, what the hell? And this is probably typical of the people who don't like me. There you go. The typical insane idiot. Complete morons. Unbelievable. So, obviously, I'm going to mute my microphone so we can actually have a serious set of gameplay here because that was such a fucking waste of time. It wasn't even, I couldn't even play. It was delayed, and I'm trying to learn stuff with a character, and he's just mashing buttons and wins because of fucking garbage, screaming like a fucking child. What an intelligent person. And by the way, he's played over 700 matches online, so... productive use of his time. What a fucking idiot.
It's remarkable to me. Just take the loss. I've played a ton of fighting games online. I get my ass kicked on the regular. I don't cry about it. Fuck. It happens. People are better than you. Learn to take the loss, man.
waste of a human life. It's too bad. There's too many people on the planet, I guess. And you get people like that. That's what happens. When there's too many people on the planet, it's overpopulated and people just have no actual, you know, reason to exist. You get people like that. And that's where you go.
Poor little Phil. He can't handle it. He cannot handle getting beaten. It just fucks with him on a level that's very deep. I don't know what in his childhood he's pulling on, but there's something there. Already saw that one. Audio of Phil getting swatted. I think I played this before on one of the previous streams. I have seen it, though. DSPism special. The ultimate snort montage? Somebody has taken the time to put this together. Let's take a look.
The following announcement has been paid for by the...
16 minutes. Boy, you're in for a treat.
Kojima World Order.
Did you like it?
You're gonna hear me snorting.
Yeah.
Gaming?
Holy shit, 16 minutes and 44 seconds of that. That is remarkable dedication that you could sit through. I don't know how much of his content you... Maybe it was just one stream. This is all probably from one stream of Phil snorting and honking nonstop. Holy shit, when you string it together like that, he really does do it a lot. Holy fucking shit, I'm going to watch a little more of this. It sounds like a fucking lawnmower that's having mechanical issues. Holy shit, and it's always the same tone. He snorts at the same tone. It's like a frequency. It's a frequency of gout. I don't know how he tunes into it specifically, but he has. We'll skip ahead a little. We'll see if it sounds different as time goes on. You could use his snorting slowed down like that as a sound effect for a Dragon's Lair or something. If you're making like a sci-fi animation or a video game and you need sound effects for monsters making nefarious noises, just slow down Phil's snorts. And there you go. It sounds like a horse. That's actually what it sounds like. It sounds like a fucking horse. I feel like I'm on a farm. I feel like I'm on a fucking farm.
Oh.
honestly didn't know it was that bad. Holy shit. I really didn't know it was that bad. I knew he snorted a lot, and I know he made the gout sounds a lot, but goddamn, how many streams was this taken from? I need to know. See if you can survive 3 minutes. Fuck, barely. All snorts are different, and none of them repeat twice in the main segment, if you can believe this insanity. This video uses most of the DSP-isms from under... Okay. Oh, God, I just want to know if that's from just like one or two videos. I saw Mad Max and the Phantom Pain and a few others. God fucking Christ, how does he make that noise so much? Chat, aren't you loving it? You're telling me you don't like that noise? You're telling me you don't want to take the sounds of his snorts, make a soundboard out of it, and then go play him in a video game and do nothing but spam them at him? How would he react if he heard nothing but snorting back at him during the entirety of a fucking two-round match? He would lose his shit. He would get so fucking catastrophically angry that you would dare snort back at him. God, I almost want to try it. What's his schedule? Does he have a schedule up? What games are he is he playing in the next month here? He doesn't know anything about Europe. Oh, I remember this one. This was fucking terrible.
It's time for another good idea, bad idea. Good idea.
No, I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Try again. A fair guess, but I'm afraid it's wrong.
Yeah, I've watched this one before, and he gets a few of them once he gets going. Oh, let's jump into this.
Province, state, or country? What?
Here we go. Let's watch this clusterfuck.
A fair guess, but I'm afraid it's wrong. Try
I don't know anything about Europe. Fuck.
Yeah, that's where the UK is.
Oh my God. Well, Paris. I don't know what the Paris. Italy. It's telling you. France. This is France. Fucking Finland. Oh, I got Germany.
Heavens!
I don't know what the United Kingdom is. Italy. I know what Italy looks like. It looks like a boot.
Try again.
What? That's bullshit. That's exactly what I did.
No, I'm sorry.
This is quite amazing.
A fair guess, but I'm afraid it's wrong.
Yeah, where's Sweden?
Heaven. I don't know these at all.
Try again.
No, I'm sorry. That is incorrect.
Maybe Greece is up there, Phil. Why did you put Greece up there? You know, fuck Norway. Let's just make it Greece.
I knew that. Ireland is one of these.
Clearly, it's a big island.
I'm afraid it's wrong.
Okay. Norway? I don't know these at all, man.
Try again.
This is wonderful. He did it. He actually fucking did it. He put Greece up there. Wow.
Wow.
But I'm afraid it's wrong.
I didn't have a clue. I don't know Europe. How the fuck would I know Europe? I live in North America, you asshole. That wasn't fair at all.
Just brilliant. That is some high-grade education. Clearly, this is a man who knows his geography. All right, well... I'm gonna call it a stream. I just wanted to get the word out there that a super secret channel, you know, keep it to yourself. You don't want to spoil the surprise for people. Super secret channel, KO Gaming has been made by somebody who may be Darkside Phil. Maybe. Might be. It's a secret. Don't tell anybody. And potentially, you're going to see amazing content on there. Again, shh, secret. Holy shit. I thought it was bad enough when he poured bacon grease down the toilet. I thought, he can't really get fucking dumber than that. That's kind of like the highlight of his stupidity, but then I saw him fail 7 times in a row, the easiest mission in a GTA game you could embark on. That really requires no effort and you could beat in probably literally a minute or 2 minutes. 7 fucking failed attempts at that. And he rage quits the game. That's brilliant. That's good stuff, Phil. High quality. Worth those Patreon dollars, buddy. Totally worth those Patreon dollars.